All right, good evening, gamers. Welcome to EREV TV. It's your boy Big Max here. Co-cast alongside of me tonight, finally back from his extended vacation. Not really, he just hasn't been around or on the right internet, but he's back. Mr. Wet the System, how you doing?
I'm going to reiterate, is this game actually real? Are we actually here? Or are we on the third level?
I'm lost. Anyway, so you are here. Of course, you're doing good. This isn't the normal starting position that we would be starting cast in. Kind of weird. Long story short, we'll get into it when we have some downtime. Playing on the Legion team is X-Men. Playing on the Hellborn team is, Ears. We got a little bit of action in the middle right now. I'm trying to give you a rundown of the heroes. You can already see a couple of them, you know, as wherever the camera guy's zooming around. We have Myrmidon and Flint in middle right now, trying to double team on this Bubbles. Bubbles playing exceptionally well against this this double team, though. As I was saying, Puppet Master, Glacius, Andro, Bubbles, and Pebbles makes up X-Men's team on Legion side. And Flint, Beastwood, Valkyrie, Zephyr, Disham, and Myrmidon make up Ears team on the Hellborn side. So, kind of a weird place to start. Yes, I know the stream didn't have any delays, so we started it as a VOD. So just, you know, bear with us, but we're here to cover the action. Anyway, Wet, anything you would like to add before we start?
Yeah, we see some really interesting lane choices, kind of unexpected. We have Bubbles in the middle and Puppet in the solo long lane. I didn't really expect that at all. I expected Bubbles to be in the solo long lane and maybe either Pebbles or Puppet middle. And we do see they're tri-laning this Pebbles, trying to get him a very, very fast portal key.
Yeah, I mean, that might be some trickery that they're going to use, or some kind of crafty tactic. And like you said before, obviously we didn't get into the theory crafting because we did that in the live stream that was no delay. But you did mention that they might try and tri-lane this, this Pebbles. So, and well, they technically are, so it was a good call. I wouldn't have expected to see Puppet in the side lane, though.
Me neither, but Pebbles is definitely their most important hero.
Got some action going on in the middle too. Got a lot of things being tossed in on that Bubbles. Andro getting a stun off on that Myrmidon. Myrmidon getting a stun off on that Andro. Surprised he didn't go for the Bubbles. Bubbles was lower, but he is going to get that kill on Andro. Andro going down super fast. Disham coming over there to attack Bubbles. Bubbles is going to shell surf out, and yes, he does get out. They're going to chase him. No. So Bubbles with a great escape there. Andro kind of came up in there and got obliterated by that Flint Myrmidon combo.
I think there was maybe some miscommunication with Andro because it looked like she went for the Flint Beastwood, but Bubbles kind of blocked Andro from being able to stun her.
Well, you know, I mean, I saw Bubbles really low, and Myrmidon was there, and Myrmidon had the combo. I mean, I guess it's because, you know, Bubbles can just dodge it, you know, with quick reflexes, as we're missing a kill up at top, where Disham and the Zephyr just got the kill on the Puppet. It looks like Disham doing a great job of roaming around and trying to get some early gank.
He also had that double damage rune, and, you know, at level 1 or 2, he has a very excellent base damage. He was hitting for over 100.
Yeah, so we are going to see some really crafty things. I've heard good things about this Ears team. Sorry, we're still getting a lot of whispers and things like that. But I've heard a lot of things about Ears. They do pull out some kind of weird strategies and things like that. So we are seeing a little bit of this going on right now. Myrmidon kind of just sitting there eyeing this Bubbles again. I see HP's dropping at bottom lane. Bubbles got hit with a arrow stun, a freeze on this Valkyrie. Valkyrie getting frozen. Pebbles coming up to try and get the kill, trying to get a stun. No. Glacius with some auto attacks. Pebbles is going to back. And more actually going on in the middle, too. Bubbles trying to chase down this Myrmidon, it looks like. Looks like Andro's going to come and cut him off. Andro's still level 1, but still got that stun. Oh, a missed silence by Bubbles. It didn't hit. A good flare. Oh, Bubbles still gets the kill. What great auto attack damage. Flint and Bubbles having
Flint's
an auto attack
to
the aura. Oh, and he gets hit by a 3.5 second arrow, but Valkyrie tries to even get the regen room. He does. He dodges the auto attack with... Oh, man. What a great leap. He's coming back in, though. He's going to call. Not sure what Valkyrie's trying to do. Wanted to call on Andro. He's not going to get it. Valkyrie just giving him the kill right there. Got way too greedy.
She was pinned. If you looked, Pebbles was coming down the river with a full bar of mana. I think she made the right call.
Okay. Well, still. I guess.
She thought, I might as well
she
put some damage on the mid hero. But she'd used all her leap already. Barring that Pebbles, Pebbles did not miss his stun, she was definitely dead. And I'm gonna have problems with Bubbles and Pebbles being on the same team, I'm already sure of that.
It's Bubbles and Pebbles. They're the same thing.
Bubbles.
Yeah. Oh, dude, could you imagine if they made Pebbles and Bubbles in one hero? That would be awesome. That would be awesome. Put Pebbles' ult away and give it Bubbles' ult, and then keep Shell Surf on Pebbles. Or Bubbles.
See Myrmidon opening up on Pebbles. Oh, it's gonna be close.
You mean Bubbles. Myrmidon yeah, tower diving, he Bubbles. Doesn't get the kill! Oh, man! That was good tower, or excuse me, tree play by Bubbles, really hiding in those trees, saved his life.
Oh, he got, the power
he got
supply too.
For 1 second.
Power supply,
see,
put
power
him
supply.
Where he could take an extra hit. Such a great item. It,
word of the
you know,
wise,
it changes the game.
Get power supply. Exactly. Wards win games, and so do power supply.
And we see Valkyrie in a really big mess right now. Oh, just evaporated.
Massacre. Yeah. You know, I think Ears needs to just relax for a second. They're trying to go on an all-out offensive, if you notice. They're really trying to get the ganks. They're trying to play hard, trying to play it aggressive. It's a good strategy. It's a good way to go about it. But of course, it's obviously not working. They're getting counter-ganked quite a bit. They need to rethink something here, Wet, and they need to rethink it quick. Because, I mean, it's still early, of course. Everything's still very even, still very early in anybody's favor. But you don't want to get too far behind by just, you know, trying to give them kills by tower diving and doing crazy stuff like that.
Yeah, I agree. They started out 0-2, so maybe they were getting a little confident, but now they're already 5-2.
Yeah, something needs to be reworked here. We're gonna see Bubble Shell surfing in on that pebble, or excuse me, God, wow. I think everybody's pebbles now. On that Flint Beastwood, Beastwood just gonna take the damage though, back up. Andrew coming in with the ore. Andrew finally level 3, he's got boots. Interesting item for Andrew, just boots. Usually I see him with like wards and things like that. No, he already has wards, he placed them. Wow, a lot of wards already down. That's what I love
it's
about
nice
these
that she
professional
already has
games.
Boots.
It is, because usually boots
pretty
is the hardest thing to do. More shells rolling out for harass. Look at Valkyrie in the woods right now. We're gonna see her in like the middle of bottom and middle right now. Nope, she's gonna go ahead and head back. Top lane Zephyr. That's right. Ear still has that Zephyr. Zephyr already having a helm of the Black Legion, doing an exceptional job of farming right now. It looks like he is doing a wee bit of jungling on his side time too. So he's definitely gonna be able to jungle a lot easier with that helm now. That's gonna pick him up some extra gold. As Valkyrie goes down again to Pebbles.
Yes, I was watching it too, and I don't think Valkyrie just realized how much momentum Pebbles already has. She walked up and was throwing out a few auto attacks, and Pebbles just ran up and killed her.
Maybe some misjudgment by Valkyrie thinking she could take on that Pebble.
He's sitting at 370 gold per minute at the moment. He has 1500 gold, already has steam boots. We're going to see a 10-minute portal key.
Yeah, mid lane too. Oh, Tether gets the stun on that Flint Beastwood right there. And Flint's gonna go down before D-Champ can port in and try and save him with the cape. But here comes Myrmidon. Myrmidon maybe trying to get a combo stun on this Bubbles and work something out, or just come up here to defend the tower. Because it looks like X-Men's getting momentum on this middle tower. Arrow being shot out. Nope, not hitting
Cancel.
Anybody. Oh no, he's just canceling it. Okay, here comes the arrow. Ooh, oh, Glacius almost walks right into it. Nice hold position right there by the Bubbles. He's not gonna get hit by that, not gonna get fooled by that Magikarp. Here comes Flint though. Flint is back. Flint usually a very typical range
Pebbles
carry.
In trouble
Flint.
Bottom with Zephyr.
Alright, wow, so many things going on. Zephyr going down bottom to take out that Pebbles. What a great pickup too. Gotta stop Pebbles before he can get that Porky. In the lane, in the bottom woods right now, we have some action going on. D-Sham gonna go ahead and get auto-attacked in middle lane too.
Middle.
We got Magikarps going out. Bubbles is about to go down. He pops the power supply, gets the last hit off. Oh, Glacius with a nice last hit because of the bubble silence AoE that he put out. Valkyrie trying to auto-attack and run. Should've just started running a nice player, but not gonna be enough. Glacius picking up a double tap right there. We see the thing going out on. Oh my god! He got mini. What an exceptional play.
Indeed, and Glacius picks up a hat trick. That's exciting.
Was it just the auto attack that got
Pebbles
before
bottom.
He gave the ult off, or?
It was shell serve and Glacius auto attack all at once, okay. And then Bubbles took cover so that Flint's ult wouldn't hit him just in case he lived.
Oh, he did take cover because that's what stopped the channeling or whatever, because it looked like Flint was going to get it off, and then all of a sudden I just didn't see Flint cast it at all. So I knew it was a good save by whoever it was, though. Man, oh man, 10-3 right now, 10 minutes in, very exciting game, 3,100 gold up and 1,200 experience up. That's for the Legion side right now. Let's go ahead and go to gold per minute right here.
Pebbles has his portal key now.
Oh, dude, that's bad news.
Even after
for ears.
Death, 11-minute portal key. Like, he pretty much had it when Zephyr killed.
Magikarp being tested out on this glacier. You should see a gust back in. There comes the gust. Bubbles are going to pop the ult, though. They're trapped in there. They can't move. Bubbles not going to go away, though. He's going to come up there and auto attack Myrmidon a couple times. Look how hard that auto attack hits Myrmidon for what? I mean, just massive damage.
He's so squishy.
More shell surfs going down. Looks like he's going for the haste rune. Andro's sitting right by it, trying to guard it. Bubbles is going to bottle up this haste rune right here. And oh, man, Bubbles with haste. That's even more lethal than just Bubbles. Or
too bad it's not Pebbles with haste. Where is Pebbles right now?
He's back at base. He is in bottom. Is he? No, he's in base. He's healing up. Zephyr's still farming though. Zephyr having some exceptional gold per minute as well. Zephyr is at 364 gold per minute, top in the game right now, doing very well. But of course, the Hellborn side has a lot more people, or the Legion side, excuse me, has a lot more people with higher gold per minutes, kind of averaging out to his. Bubbles and Pebbles both high up on that gold per minute wet, and it's very dangerous for the Hellborn.
It's about to get worse too, because they're going to take this middle tower without any competition, it looks like.
Yeah, D-Shop's trying to come up in there. Oh, Pebbles just ports in and just obliterates Valkyrie right there. Zephyr getting in the mix of things. He's going to drop down the ult. He's going to get Tornado so he can heal. They're moving out of the Tornadoes really fast, so he doesn't have enough mana to Gust. Myrmidon coming up in there with a nice sweep, but he doesn't get the hit on Pebbles because Pebbles out fog. Glacius all dropping down on Zephyr. Look at D-Shop in the back. No throwing out cape. No throwing out heals. D-Shop's going to go down. Bubbles lives with a nice shell surf out. Three go down for that Hellborn team. Wet.
This Bubbles is playing his health bar perfectly every time. That is the third time he's dropped to 10% or lower HP and gotten away.
Yeah, this Bubbles, and this is why Bubbles really deserves a ban. He's a really good ban. If you're not going to ban him, make sure you can first pick him because he's very lethal if played correctly. I mean, I've seen this in countless games where Bubbles just, he's exceptional. He's everywhere. He gets in and out. I mean, he's not the hero you want to have playing on the other team. I'll tell you that much.
Yeah, and I doubted X-Men's lane choices at first, but it looks like Puppet managed to pick up his levels and do just fine. But look at this Valkyrie. Valkyrie had the solo lane against the Pebbles tri-lane, didn't do very well. We see Pebbles initiating on Flint Beastwood and getting him, but he's going to go down himself. I think it's probably worth it, though. They've got enough momentum that they can afford to lose a Pebbles just to keep their carries pressed down.
Yeah. Flint technically being their hard carry, and he's not doing too well right now. Sitting at 190 gold per minute, 0-4-2. So he's definitely way, way far behind. Now we see Andrew right there dropping some wards of revelation. Didn't pick up on him in the woods right there. Could have gotten a nice kill on him. Looks like momentum going middle right now for X-Fin. They're kind of just farming around. Puppet's at bottom. Puppet's been very out of this game. And he doesn't have a lot of items to show for it either. But he's been usually just free. Oh, he did get ganked up there too up. Against Zephyr. Yeah. Anyway, so we have a very big gathering of the Legion. Excuse me, God, I keep getting mixed up. I swear, of the Hellborn team's team in the forest up at top lane. A Valk arrow gonna come out. It might hit somebody. What an amazing port by Pebbles, and he dodges it. Tosses Zephyr away, so he can't get the ult. He is gonna ult in the trees. He can't heal because he's stunned. Amazing. No overlapping of stuns, perfect timing, an amazing chuck, missed port key, or missed the arrow by the port key, just superb playing overall. Myrmidon's gonna go down, it looks like. Great stuns, great support by Andrew. Cape in mid-air, not gonna hit him. Pebbles going over there, doing the chuck up in the air, gets a double tap, and looks like we're gonna see a top tower go down to X-Men.
Oh yeah, this Pebbles has a lot of momentum, and he's only gonna hit harder in one more level.
Most definitely. I mean, Pebbles is lethal. The thing with Pebbles is if you outlevel the other team, you get the port key. The other team has a lot of squishies you can easily get to. Pebbles is going to just ransack your team all day long. He's so lethal. And it's the same with Bubbles, too. Bubbles is just an amazing hero. I love Bubbles. I love to see him, and I'm glad we get to see him a lot. I'd love to see Bombardier more, but I haven't seen Bombardier in a while, Whit. I'm kind of sad.
His boom dust is still really powerful, but after the nerf, he kind of lost his competitive edge a little bit.
Well, I'd still like to see somebody come back and play him. It's nice to see Chipper, though, get played and deserve a ban as well, because Chipper is another really exciting hero to watch in these competitive team plays and things like that, with those rockets and things like that. It's always fun to watch when there's a Chipper on one team and a Vindicator on the other team, though, because it just it really hurts Chipper. Ports in everywhere. We got action and everything. Andrew taking on that flip right there. Pebbles going in on that that team right there. Pebbles going to get up. He's got the Haze Rune. 4.5 seconds stun on Pebbles, though. Are they going to get him down in 4.5 seconds? A great swap by Andrew. Pebbles still goes down, though, to Flint. Andrew's going to go down. A great pickup by the Hellborn team. Perhaps a comeback. Perhaps. 10,000 gold ahead is the Legion and 5,000 experience. We got a little bit of downtime. Why don't we go up into items for this Hellborn team? What do they have right now? What do they look like they're going for?
On the Hellborn team, we have Flint Beastwood, who is going a lot of survivability items first. He's got his Steam Boots on Strength. He went and picked up his Mighty Blade. He could be using that to make a Shrunken Head to kind of counter Pebbles, maybe, or go ahead and get his Frost Sword for the slow effect. We have Valkyrie, who is a little behind. She hasn't even picked up any of her core items. She hasn't finished her boots yet, but I think she will after this short jungle escapade. Zephyr is still sitting on the same items he was on earlier. Maybe he is saving up for a mock. He's got 1,000 gold saved up, so I'm not sure. And the two support heroes are just sitting on basic support items. Puppet Master, on the other hand, does have his Whispering Helm. Pebbles picked up a Mystic Vestments to match his portal key so he doesn't get blown up whenever he ports in on someone.
Alrighty, I was about to say, got some action going on in the middle.
Glacius has a Glowstone.
Think he's going for Steph, or think he Frostful Skull, or what?
I guess. Or maybe he just said, I want some health and I have a lot of money. Oh, we see Myrmidon just destroyed by Pebbles.
Alright. So we technically are seeing some great play going on right there. Missed a little scuffle in middle lane. Bubbles was taking on two heroes at once, but nothing came of that. Actually, yes, it did, actually. I think Pebbles ported and killed Myrmidon, and he did the same thing to DS just right then. Pebbles is now level 11, level 2 ult. He's just hitting harder. He's going to continue hitting harder, as Wet said, as the game keeps going on. And, I mean, it's going downhill right here. They can't counter the Pebbles. They can't get out to farm because they have to worry about Pebbles, and they can't win a team fight, Wet. So there's so much against the Hellborn team right now.
Yeah, it's going to be tough. And once Pebbles, I think he's going to go for Spell Shards. Most Pebbles do. And once he gets that, it's just even worse. It lowers his cooldowns. It increases his attack speed. Spell Shards were pretty much made for Pebbles. It's his best item, in my opinion.
Yeah, I mean, not to mention that Pebbles' cooldowns aren't too exorbitant. I mean, they're not very long, but even that 9%, I mean, that makes a huge difference. He gets to stun combo that much quicker, and it's lethal every time he does.
It's pretty much extra. It's 2 seconds off his stalagmites and 1 second off his chuck. I think it's noticeable.
Oh, it definitely is. I mean, and not to mention that just because Pebbles is so mobile with all the movement speed and with his portal key and things like that, I mean, he's just an overall well-rounded hero, especially with spell shards. I mean, look at that. He misses a stun and a chuck on Zephyr, though, but he is going to go in an auto attack. Look at that auto attack beast on it. Zephyr's not even going to have time to react. He's silenced. He's stunned. He can't do anything. No heals from DS going out. We did see one go down. Glacius did go down. Andrew is very low. Pebbles coming back in, though, comboing on that DS right there. DS is down. Flint Beastwood trying to auto attack around. We see Puppet coming in there, hitting him a nice whiplash, holding Flint in place. Flint trying to get over there. He's going to get the flare off, but he is going to go down. Pebbles still chasing this Myrmidon, stalking this Myrmidon right now. Valkyrie coming up, though. Myrmidon tossing back. Just a Kelp field trying to get away, and three go down, while two go down on the Legion side.
Yeah, a really good team fight there. Unfortunate that Pebbles missed his stalagmites, or it also would have probably been a lot different. But you saw that Glacius ultimate. Man, it seemed like every shard happened to hit Zephyr. He went down so fast.
Yeah, Zephyr got really, his HP really tanked. And, you know, he got the silence on him. He got stunned by Andro. He even caught a bit of the damage from the Chuck. I believe the Chuck hit him, not the stun. So he still got some initial damage, and then Pebbles delivered like this huge auto attack. I mean, Pebbles hits for so much damage. I mean, look at those clones beat away on that catapult, and he just combos Valkyrie. Valkyrie didn't go down, but it was a very strong combo right there, and Pebbles is gonna get out without getting comboed.
Yeah, look at Pebbles' base damage. It's almost 200.
And this early on, I mean, if you look at some of these Hellborn heroes, I mean, DS is still sitting at normal the armor, it looks like. No, excuse me, he does have 6 armor, or actually only 16.7 physical damage reduction. I mean, that's nothing. Pebbles is going to walk up and hit him for as hard as a chipper rocket would hit him, you know? And he can just auto-attack like crazy, and he still has a spell. So Hellborn team needs to really watch out, especially Valkyrie and DS and Myrmidon, their potential targets. For this Pebble.
You can see what type of effect Pebbles has on a game once he gains momentum. Look at the tower situation. This early in the game, almost all the outer towers on the Hellborn team is gone. That's simply because they're I would say afraid to come out and defend them, because the first support hero with inside of Pebbles is just going to take it.
Exactly. I mean, that's why I try to tell you, they can't really get out and farm. Look at them, they're in the base trying to farm. So they're so clumped up, they're not getting good experience, and they can't really win team fights. They haven't had good luck with team fights. They can't lock down Pebbles. Zephyr can't gain any presence in the team fights enough to make a difference at least, and Flint Beast with a super under farm. They need to go for it.
Yeah, I was looking at Valkyrie's skill build, and that is the typical skill build, not to level your invis until you finish your call in Javelin, but I think in this situation, you should kind of change up what you do given the situation, and you should really have that invis skill. Very strong, and now they're stuck in these team fights. They either have to deal with a team fight, or they just have to stay in bay.
Yeah, I mean, and we're gonna see a teamfight going on now. Zephyr's gonna drop down right there. Myrmidon pop is all smacking on somebody right there, not doing much damage. DS is just in the mix right there. Low HP, he's tossing out heals. He's trying to do whatever he can. Pebbles is down though, so their main threat is gone. A nice bullet going over there for the Bubbles. Glacius can auto attack down. A nice flare going out. Maybe some comeback here. 2 are going down. 3 are going down. 3 are down. Andrew trying to get away. Is she going to get away? I think we're going to have a Magikarp coming out. She's trying to get into the woods. She has a TP. She is going to TP. Are we going to see a Magikarp in time? Oh,
Magikarp
wouldn't
have done anything.
Puppet coming up in the mix right now. Not sure exactly what he's doing. Oh man, he's going for it though. He could turn around and whiplash that DS. He'd probably die, and I think that's what he's trying to do. Nope. Looks like the team's gonna back, and Puppet is gonna back. But here comes Bubbles. Looks
coming.
Like Bubbles bought back. Bubbles bought back. He's gonna. Oh my God, who's got the sheep stick? Bubbles has the sheep stick. Wow.
Yeah, he used it earlier on Zephyr. That's a really good team fight for in Ear's favor.
The
I don't think they expected the Bubbles to come back though.
No, I don't think they expect that either, but that was a very good team fight by the Hellborn team. They played it well, and they got the upper hand on that team fight for the most part until the end, and then, yeah. Well, I mean,
Zephyr
it was
almost
three
survived through it, too. Like, it was really close. Like, it was just really well done by their team.
Zephyr looks like he is going to pick up a shrunken head, or at least try really hard to pick up one. Mach is just out of the question right now. He needs survivability. He just needs to be in team fights. Pebbles coming up in there, though. Going to combo on this Myrmidon. A 3-second stun. He's going to get gusted back. Maybe a little overlapping of stuns. They could have waited. And a nice swap by Andrew.
Andrew swap.
Andrew's going to go down, though, but not before stunning on that Myrmidon. Looks like Zephyr's just caught in the mix right there. He does have his tornadoes. Nobody in range of his ult, though. A great Bubbles ult. He's going to defensively use his ult, but then they're going to turn around and use it in offense because Myrmidon's going to be standing there. He didn't move out of the way of the shell. He came back in. Pebbles is back up in here with HP, beating on the Zephyr, going over for this Flint Beastwood. Not going to let this Flint Beastwood live. Zephyr with a great gusto, taking out almost two of them. Didn't pick up both the kills, but at least he did enough damage. Zephyr's gonna get auto attack down along with shells and all that whiplashing and stuff like that. And Valkyrie, Valkyrie's trying to get away. Valkyrie gets away, but D'Shem is not as lucky. Valkyrie coming back though, trying to get a kill in that bubbles. No. Woo. Anyway.
How are you doing, Wet?
Exciting. It was exciting, dude. That's what I love. I love this stuff.
We had some overextension by both teams, and that's why that ended up being so exciting.
Yeah, I mean, there was a lot of back and forth on that team fight. Oh, man, Bubbles with that ult, and then he used it to a defensive-offensive advantage. It was perfect. It was perfect by both sides. I mean, Hellborn team looked like they were really going to get the upper hand in that until Pebbles got away with a nice Andro swap.
Oh yeah, it would have been a different story if Pebbles would have went down earlier. He got to come in and throw his stun out one more time, and that's what probably won it for the Legion team. It's good to see that the Hellborn team is actually trying to make a legitimate comeback. They're still very, very behind. They need to get some tower kills if they're going to have any chance. And that's going to be really difficult with the Pebbles running level 12 on their team when it looks like they're actually starting to catch up in levels and survivability.
You know, I'm starting to worry less about this Pebbles and worry more about this Bubbles and this Puppet Master. Puppet Master's actually getting a very good farm. We're looking at Puppet Master now. He's going some interesting items, alright? It's not the typical Puppet Master items we see, but he's definitely getting some good farm. We're going to see a Valkyra come out somewhere, I believe. There it is. He's gonna hit 5 seconds on that Puppet Master. Are they gonna get up to him? They're trying to rally to get him. A great defensive ult by Bubbles right there. He's looking important in. Glacius with a nice ult on the edge, so they have a reduced time of, or excuse me, reduced sight of hitting him. I believe that doesn't really matter anyway. Zephyr trying to get away. No, he's not gonna get away. Hellborn team trying to do something here. Flare's being shot out. So many Legion members at low HP. Just auto attack him. They're trying to do it. Pebbles is still alive. TS with his final stand. He is gonna go down. Genocide 27-27. Yeah, kind of ironic. Double digits, man. Anyway, and they're gonna finish up Congo right here, and the gold difference and the experience difference just keep rising.
That was a really fun team fight. You saw that Bubbles ultimate hit all five players.
Yeah,
they're all sitting ducks.
It was a great Bubbles ult. He did it up at top lane. He did it again down here. It's got a very short cooldown, and even though it doesn't do that much damage, it does its job. I mean, it is such a good ult.
Check out this carry Glacius. He's got token.
I got a whisper from Lag TT's in Zanami who said, go China, what you call it, carry Glacius. He is gonna have this token of life. Look at that Glacius, man, the star player, MVP. No, most definitely though, if X-Men does take this one, MVP must go to Bubbles. Regardless of Pebbles' superb playing, that Bubbles is something of the next world, but I've rarely see playing like that. That is some really good playing.
We're actually not seeing Pebbles pick up spell shards. I think that's surprising. He has a Blessed Orb, maybe. I don't actually know what he'd be going with Blessed Orb. I don't see why you'd get a Null Stone on this team.
Yeah, I don't either. I mean, he could be going for a Sheep Stick just for lulls or more CC, maybe. I'm not sure.
Pebbles with a Sheep Stick, okay. I can dig it.
Hey! I think that would be a really interesting item. I mean, I'm gonna give a little, maybe a little noobish to say that, but I think it would be a really interesting item to see Pebbles come out with a Sheep Stick. I mean, come on, Pebbles can have a Sheep Stick. We'll know sooner or later what he plans on doing with that Blessed Orb.
We got this Glacius stealing creep kills from the Puppet Master. It's so funny.
I think X-Men's a wee bit tired, as a couple of their members have been saying that they want to go to bed, so they're just trying to end it, it looks like. And the Hellborn team is just like trapped in their own base. They can't even get out. You don't have mobility. Look at the ward game too. What if you notice all around here, there are wards everywhere. They basically control their force. They control their base, half of it. I mean, they're busting into top lane right now. They want this Rax, and I think if they get this Rax, it might seal the deal.
Oh yeah, I think the deals are even sealed. I've seen people come back from these deficits before, but they at least had some map advantage.
Yeah. And they don't have it, and they don't even have map control or map sight. I mean, they don't have anything. They don't even know what's coming at them. And nice 5 seconds spear on that creep.
The ice ogre.
That's good sportsmanship, though. Both of these teams, I had a long time waiting to play this game, and yes, I know there's a team fight going down, and I should be pulling out a bottle of water right now and saying H2O. But I mean, we are seeing some great sportsmanship right now. It's all fun and games. I love to see this. What's so good about this Han community? You know, a 4 second sum on that Puppet Master. Flint Beast was trying desperately just to get something done. Disham coming up in there. Valkyrie went down. It looks like Bubbles is down as well. I think they're going to rally up here and still take this Rax. Disham's going to get slaughtered, and yes, he does. But Flint Beast with taking it to that Pebbles. He's going to get puppet showed and swapped. A nice stun by Andrew, and they're going to chain on that Flint. And another genocide here at 31-15. And I think we should see this Rax to fall.
At first, the Hellborn team successfully defended it.
Glacius goes Legion down, out. But he has the token. Oh, sorry to cut you off. I forgot.
No, you're fine. Glacius
has the token. He's going to get comboed, though, but it looked like he was going to freeze Myrmidon, and then it quickly froze Valkyrie. I think that was a great choice right there. Even though they could still cast Valkyrie, would have been the absolute choice to freeze right there. Glacius can auto-attack down, though. This Hellborn team isn't giving up. Here comes Zephyr. Zephyr's going to probably try to drop it in all. Maybe Gustavson. A great slow. A great slow by Glacius. Look at Zephyr. He can't catch up. Myrmidon trying to get away. A whiplash by his clone. Look at Puppet's clone go. Look at this clone. Is it going to get him? Oh, it stops attacking.
Bubble says post-haste, he's coming in.
Oh, man, I thought that clone was gonna get him wet.
Bubble's taking it post-haste, is just rubbing salt into the wounds.
Yeah, I mean, now he can be everywhere, and then everywhere as well as everywhere, so he technically is everywhere at all times. Shell surf though, look at the shell surf to the shell, whatever, what's that called? Take cover, that's it. Well, yeah. Man, take cover, you could do it so many times for so long. It's only got like a 3 second cooldown. Look at him though, tanking that damage. He's gonna go down though, Pebbles is coming up in there, they're just trying to get killed now. Unbreakable saves Pebbles. Or excuse me, saves Flint Beastwood. I'm sorry.
It's just some good banter going out between the team.
Yeah.
It was just reading chat. Kind of absorbing
exactly.
It.
Anyway, I mean, it's a good game, and I like this. Everybody's all laughing and fun, and I say this a lot, but it's what really makes a good game. I mean, regardless of how the game outcome, or how the outcome...
And it's definitely, the Legion are definitely going to win. There's no doubt about it. I won't go as far as say it's completely impossible for the Hellborn to win, but we're still getting great team fights out of this game.
Yeah, and you know, that's what's good. The Hellborn team... I think they realize that, X-Men wants to go to bed, some of their members, and maybe they're just trying to say, well, you know, hey, we're playing this out. So it's kind of like back and forth, but it's all fun and games in the end. So we are here. We are going to continue this somewhat live coverage of this game that got off to a really rocky start, even before the game even started. But at least you're having fun in your no-stats game.
Oh, yeah. I was stomping with that electrician, man.
That's nice. I'm glad. I'm glad you get to have fun while I'm sitting in here waiting for two teams to get together and, you know, play a damn game of Han. I've waited a long time to see Disham, unbreakable armor, and he's dead. Excuse me, not Pebbles. Who has the port key? Who just came up in there? Was that Bubbles? Oh, Bubbles. Bubbles with the Porky and post-haste. Let's see, that's what I'm telling you, Wet. He can be everywhere and everywhere at the same time.
So
it doesn't even matter.
Pebbles does have a sheepstick.
I told you! See? Sheepstick. Pebbles. Isn't that hilarious? It's actually a really cool item if you think about it. He gets to port in, stun one, and then sheep the other one. I mean, All right, we are going to see Conceit. I was kind of waiting for that. I mean, not to be rude or anything. We are going to switch quickly into another game, though. So any final comments?
No, great game. Let's get going.
All right. We're going to see you guys in the other game. It'll probably be voted up. So by the time you're done watching this, the other game should be up or almost done. So anyway, live here from EREV TV. I'm Big Max. He's with the system. Yeah, we're here. And we're not queer. Anyway, yeah, see you in the other cast.
Okay.